The Bible is an idol. Now, I want to teach you a mystery today, and you're a sinner and don't even know it. Let me explain it to you. Very, very powerful. In Revelation 17 and 4, "And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication." Now, that's the old whore that sets upon many waters. Now, let me tell you the mystery. And then in Mystery Babylon. Now think about the kings and ones that committed fornication with the old whore. And in Revelations 18 and 16 said, "And saying, Alas, alas, that great city that was clothed in fine linen and purple and scarlet and decked with gold and precious stones and pearl." Does that sound familiar? The 17th chapter and the 4th verse and the 18th chapter and the 16th verse said, "Was clothed in fine linen and purple and scarlet and decked with gold and precious stones and pearl, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of abominations and filth of her fornication." So you see, the church is in cahoots with the flesh, with the kings of the earth and all. Now I'm going to show you a little mystery where you participate in this. You're the cause of this. All of you are. And I want to show it to you very plain and simple so that you will not be messed up, because Jesus is bringing forth some truth here to show you why he's going to destroy the world. This is the last message before the two witnesses come. This is the message with the angel with the book in his hand. You must prophesy this. Okay, what people are doing, I'm going to show you right now, and listen really close. You've heard this. If you go to church, you've heard this a blue million times. "Will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me. But you say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings." Now think about that. You go every week and you give them 10% of your money and you wonder how the old whore and Mr. Babylon got all the money. You gave it to them. You gave it to them. You broke the law of God. You don't supposed to go by the law. They got that from the law. Now let me explain this to you. You should know it already. Israel had 12 tribes. And they came into the promised land. Well, they had one tribe called Levi. And Levi took care of all the matters of the temple and the matters of holy things. They made the offerings, the sacrifice. That was like Aaron and them. He wore the priest's clothes and all. So they came from the tribe of Levi. Well, they did not get no inheritance in Israel. They didn't get no land or nothing. They got 1/10 of the people's goods and they'd bring it to the temple. He said, "Bring all the tithes into the storehouse." They bring the tithes into the storehouse. "And I'll bless you. I'll pour you out a blessing," said God. That was under the law. Now, you know the temple's been tore down. There's no tribe of Levi left. They're all scattered throughout the world. And Jesus said it's finished. He finished this law on the cross. But what did the devil do? He took the Bible and made it the word of God and make you keep the Sabbath day holy. Makes you pay tithes because it's under the law. And the apostles said, "We gave no such commandment that you have to be circumcised and keep the law." Now what you have done, all you whoremongers with this whore, this harlot, and think about how many billions of dollars the Catholic Church and the Protestant churches have paid out for molesting little children. You know who gave them that money? You did. You helped molest little children. You're a sinner. And you're going to stand before God as a Bible worshiper. And as a sinner, and you're in serious trouble, very serious trouble. God sent me to tell you these truths by getting you ready for the last days. He wants you to know why you're being destroyed. He wants you to know why troubles are coming. He wants you to know that you're trying to keep the law. See, you keep the part of the law that you like. The church knows this is a lie. They know that this was for Levi. They know it was for the tribe of Israel that had no inheritance. When Paul and them set up churches, they put a pastor or deacon in charge of something. They didn't have no offerings. They didn't make sacrifices. He says, "As a man purposes in his heart, let him give." You know, they'd help one church might help another church. But they didn't pay tithes like they did. They had inheritance with God. We're heirs with God now. How are you going to pay tithes into that? This is our heirship. We're joint heirs with Jesus Christ and heirs with the Holy Father. So you see, you supported the devil. What you did, you molested little children. You've caused all kinds of trouble. Go to Rome and look at Peter's Basilica. You helped build that. You helped build the Pope that you worship. And so it all goes down like this. You have a earnest desire to do something for God, so you take and give them your money. And so it said they was clothed in fine linen, purple and scarlet, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, because you gave it to them. You supported the devil. You're a devil worshiper. You take the Bible as the Word of God, and it's the mark of the beast. And you support these devils because you think it's the Word of God. When how much money did they have in Joel Osteen's safe when somebody broke into it down there the other day, a few months back in the news? $600,000. A lot of you people will work and give tithes into that church down there, and you won't even make $600,000 in your whole life. They had that in just one offering down there. They had it in the safe in there. They don't want it to come out in the public very much, so they covered it up because they take in bukus of money because you give it to them. And you give it to them and you're worshiping an idol and you're taking the mark of the beast, and God's going to get you hired for that because you supported this. You built this. You gave them 10%, and then a lot of you leaves the will to them, gives them offerings and everything. This is of the devil. This is one of the biggest ripoffs. If you had all the bank robbers from Jesse James right on down, all of them that robbed banks and trains and stole on Wall Street, old Burnoff and all them, stole all them billions of dollars, it wouldn't be a drop in the bucket to these trillions of dollars that you've given to the churches. And this is why they're so rich, and this is why they have such power. You'll never tear them down. They're not going to give it up making that kind of money. They get 10% of all the people. 2 billion, 200 million Christians give 10%, and then they give offerings besides that. They're rich, rich, rich. And you made the devil rich. You made the devil rich. You're a devil, and you've done a lot of evil, and you're going to pay for it, and God's going to get you for that. You robbed God. It said, will a man rob God? You robbed God and took it from those poor people and gave it to the devil. And now you're going to pay because you killed a lot of little children by giving devils all that amount of money. Thank you, Jesus.